What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Trustless Treasures Show, where we talk about all things crypto, NFT, blockchain, anything related. Today, we're going to talk about the Benji Bananas play-to-earn game linked with the Primate token, and also talk a little bit about the APE token that's involved in this ecosystem as well. All right, guys, so first, we're going to start talking about their first season rewards campaign, which they talked about back in May, where you had to go out and buy something called the Benji Banana Membership Pass NFT out on OpenSea. I did go ahead and purchase this before the rewards campaign, so just kind of walk you guys through my journey, what I paid, what that return looks like, and what the future looks like for the Benji Banana member token. So essentially, for the reward, you had to go out and purchase this Benji Banana membership pass. Then you come in and link your wallet to BenjiBananas.com. Then you do have to KYC, I believe, and then actually link that to your Apple App Store or Google Play store on the Android, so that when you play this game, because it is all backed by a play-to-earn mobile game that I'll show you here in just a minute. So once you get all squared away in here, you would be eligible for the first season rewards. I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about those first season rewards, what they were when we received the tokens, and then what that looks like now. So essentially, there was 4 weeks where they dropped these Primate tokens to us as a reward for the first season program. Week one dropped, so they did kind of a weekly drop. However, if the weekly drops increased if you were a holder of that pass throughout the entire cycle. So for those folks who bought it later in the reward season, obviously they didn't get it as much, but I wanted to just share, kind of put this together to show you kind of what this rewards look like. And I think answer the big question was, is it worth it or was it worth it to purchase that pass? So I'm going to quickly cover a little bit of stats on the membership pass here. So there are 5,000 in total. And the first season rewards were based on how many of those were sold. They were just split up evenly amongst the owners of that pass. So if only 2,000 were sold, obviously those folks would get a bigger share of the rewards. And I think during this cycle, they were roughly around, let's see, I think there are roughly 3K owners right now. So still 2,000 out there for purchase. But I purchased mine for 0.191 ETH, which at the current time in May, that ETH was roughly 2K. So I paid $385 for that membership rewards pass. It is currently at $103. So as you guys know, everything is down right now. So not super upset about that. But here's a look at what those rewards were throughout that cycle. So in total here, and you can see because I was a holder all 4 weeks, I did get a little bit more than if you would have bought this halfway through. We got a bonus in week two for holding that pass as well. So in total, I received 13,800 Primate tokens throughout the 4 weeks as rewards for holding that and playing the Benji Bananas game. Those tokens are currently at a value of $0.015. So a total rewards value of $207. Now, one thing that you can do with those tokens, they are available on SushiSwap to be swapped for the APE token. And that's originally how I got into this project, or how I was even made aware of it. I'm a big fan of the APE token and wanted to get in on another program in their ecosystem. And so this was a way to do that and to just experiment with a small purchase amount. So current value here was 207. I did swap all of mine for APE token, which got me 49.4 APE tokens at a current value of $4.33. So you can see gained a couple dollars here, essentially paid for my gas to swap that into APE. So total ROI on the pass is negative right now. We're in the red, but I am still a little bullish overall on the Benji Bananas pass, as they just are starting to announce this play to earn mechanism where you will need to hold this pass to continue to get rewards on into the future. And this game is actually pretty cool. So the way they're planning to reward us yet, the details haven't fully been shared, but they're planning to explore 5 aspects of gameplay that will combine and weigh into the performance of rewards distribution, really in the matter of distance, total bananas, and total games played. So I'll keep you guys posted as we learn more about what this play to earn mechanism is. Also, just wanted to let you guys know there's also a Primate Ape Sushi Swap Onsen pool I really haven't gotten into this. This is a little beyond me, and I think you just earned sushi tokens for doing that. Not honestly, full disclosure, don't have a whole lot of insight into the sushi ecosystem, so not a big deal for me. But wanted to just share a little bit about this gameplay, show you guys what the game is. So this is backed by Animoca Brands, who, if you're not familiar, they do have a pretty good following, have done a lot of things in the past. So bullish on them in general. So essentially this game, it's a little monkey guy. You swing through these vines and try to collect bananas along the way. And each map or world, as they call it, it gets a little more difficult to do so. So as you can see here, this first one is pretty easy. I'm not a big fan of that balloon deal, so I'm going to just try to get through these worlds as quick as I can so you guys do see a little bit about what this game is all about. So entering into world two, then the bananas double are relative to the world you're in. So world two, the bananas are worth two times as much as they were in world one, and so on. So world three, they just continue to become worth more. This stupid balloon, I don't like it, so I try to crash. There are several different things in the game that you can get, like a balloon, a rocket. You can ride a plane. You can do lots of different things. You can swing on vines, and if you just saw there, those other green things, like this guy right here, that's a snake, and you can see you can't swing as far on a snake. It kind of like rips out of your hand there. So they also have these spiky things that you'll see that kind of throw you up in the air. Those can be pretty annoying. So jumping into world four here, where I think this is kind of the spike world, you'll see lots of those here. But you can see up in the right-hand corner, they are tracking my total distance and the total bananas. And you can currently spend these bananas in the store. You can buy things like, you know, that little ape or that little cape that I had on my back. You can buy things to level that up and lots of stuff like that. As you can see here, this is a tiger world. These tigers, if you don't have something called a tiger smack, one tiger will take you out of the game. But you can go in here and then buy things like a tiger smack. So I do buy these because if you don't, the tigers will take you right out, but they are 500 bananas for each one of those. So these are all the things that you can level up. You know, a vine, this thing makes the vines longer. We got a wingsuit that makes you glide longer, swing boost, etc. So overall, pretty cool game in general, and super excited to see what this play to earn model looks like. And look forward to collecting additional primate tokens in the future and hopefully get my ROI back in the green, and also kind of enjoying just the ride and learning more about what this whole play to earn ecosystem will look like as this model is starting to gain in popularity and lots of folks are jumping on board. So guys, I hope you got some value out of that, just learning a little bit more about a project that I'm experimenting in, and we'll keep you guys posted as we learn more and as we get more info on what play to earn looks like and what rewards might look like. But if you did get any value out of today's show, drop a like below or a subscribe if you haven't done so already. If there's a project out there that you're excited about, you want to learn more about, and you think it'll be cool for me to do some research on and shoot a video, drop that in the comments below, and I'd be happy to add that to my list, as I just enjoy kind of exploring and experimenting with all the projects in the space right now. But with that, guys, we'll go ahead and wrap. Thanks again for watching the Trustless Treasure Show, and we'll catch you next time.